What's going on, everyone? Welcome back to the Fit with Faith podcast. I'm your host, Jessica Young. If you're new here, thank you so much for being here. I hope you enjoyed today's episode. If you are returning, I hope you enjoyed today's episode too. And thank you so much for coming back. If you guys can leave me a review, rate the podcast, I'd really appreciate it. It helps me out, lets me know if I'm doing good. And if you guys are enjoying this, just leave me a comment. Let me know if there's something you want me to talk about, and I will certainly look at those, obviously. But let's get into it. Last week, we talked about the plague of progress. We talked about how sometimes this progress that our society makes and that our world makes can actually pull us farther from God. And I think it's very accurate, honestly. I think that a lot of people are so caught up in this, like, go, go, go mentality, as well as like the next best thing, that oftentimes we don't hear God, but then we're so anxiety ridden about having the next best thing that we're just burnt out and we're tired. So today I really want to talk about that, because I think when you're tired, that gives more room for doubt and for fear and for anxiety and depression. And honestly, when you're tired, the devil has more access to you. So the theme that I kind of want to encompass today's episode is something that I say often. It's, if the devil can't take you out, he'll try to wear you out. Because like I said, when you're tired, he can do more to you. He can get in your mind a lot easier because you're not fully aware. And so like in the Bible, it says to be sober-minded. And that doesn't always mean alcohol. That doesn't always mean drugs. If you're so tired that you are not thinking clearly, the devil is going to come and he is going to get into your mind. And it's going to be a lot easier for him if you are tired and you're unaware of his presence and you're unaware of his tricks. So today, it's episode 19. Let's get into it. Grab some coffee, grab some tea, buckle up, sit down, wherever you're at, and let's discuss being lost at sea when fatigue and doubt take you over. Everybody. Thank you, Jody Benson. Thank you, Little Mermaid, for explaining exactly how we all feel. I hope you enjoyed that little intro, because truthfully, when I titled this message Lost at Sea, no, that was not the song I thought of. However, did it happen to directly correlate with a lot of what my message is? 100%. Because in that song, I'm sure many of you know, Ariel's talking about like getting out of the ocean and living a different life and exploring new things and how she feels so restricted. And you know, that's where we're at. We are all lost at sea right now. Now, maybe not all of us. If you're one of the few that aren't, congratulations. Kudos to you. But you know, if you're anything like me, you see people doing the things you want to do or living the life you want to live, and you say a few things to yourself, and one of them being like, one day that'll be me. Just like Ariel did in the song, you know? And there's nothing more frustrating sometimes when you see everyone doing these things you want to do and getting the things you want while you're over here like, hey, when's it gonna be my turn? Someday it'll be my turn, right? Right. Or did I miss something? Was there like some sign-up sheet that I was supposed to put my name on to get these things? Because there was. I never saw it, never got it. Haven't wrote my name down. I'd really like to write my name down. So if someone could like send me this list, you know, like PDF file type of deal. Yeah, I'll do it. I'll put my name on it. I'll be good to go. Listen, I'm right there with you. If you feel lost, if you're struggling right now, trust me, I got you. I understand. And you're not alone. You're not wrong. You're human. And how you feel right now about this whole situation that you're in is completely valid. However, with that being said, I do want to provide you with some encouragement so you don't feel like you're stuck anymore. And one of the first things I want to read is Isaiah 40:31. And I'm prepared this time. My Bible is open. So Isaiah 40:31 says, But those who trust in the Lord will find new strength. They will soar high on wings like eagles, and they will run and not grow weary. They will walk and not faint. So, when I tell you that the theme of this podcast, in a way, is if the devil can't take you out, he'll wear you out, that's something you need to understand, is that when you trust in God, when you give everything to God, when you call on him when you're tired, when you give your anxieties to him, when you give your problems to him, when you pray to him consistently in the right way, he will help you. The devil will never help you. The devil will only hurt you. And so I have a few points I want to make in this episode, but before I do that, I want to remind you of something. We serve a God that will test us, not tempt us. And if you need evidence to that, I want you to look at all the tests that Jesus put the disciples through versus the temptation that the devil put Jesus through. So whenever there's temptation to do something, you'll find the devil's presence. However, when there's a test of faith, that's where you'll find God's presence. And unfortunately, they can coexist at the same time. So, without further ado, point number one. You need to understand that there is nothing wrong with you. Now, you are not behind. There's nothing wrong with you, and it's okay. You're going to be okay. So you may or may not have rolled your eyes at me or did the, yeah, okay, sure, Jess. There's nothing wrong with me. Everyone's just married, and everyone has kids, and I'm single, and I'm this age, and I'm that age, and I don't have the job I want, and I'm struggling, and I'm tired, and I'm not sleeping, and I'm not eating, and da-da-da-da-da. All the things. I'm sure that kind of all went through your head at one time. As soon as I said, there's nothing wrong with you. Like, you're not behind. Listen, we all go through different things. We're all meant for different things. And none of us are made the same. Which makes me always wonder, especially when I was like preparing for this podcast, it really made me wonder, why do we constantly compare our lives to others and expect our lives to match theirs? When we're not made the same, but yet we want the same life, or we think we're supposed to have the same life as someone else. Isn't that kind of ironic? Like, we all want to be different, and you hear people say, like, I'm just doing me, man. Like, I'm just out here doing me, or whatever the heck people say. I don't know. Yet at the same time, you think your life is supposed to look like theirs, or it should, because we're the same age. I have a better job. I should be married by now. They're married. What do they have that I don't have? I make more money than them. I do this. I do that. I. You sound like the stinking little birds from Finding Nemo. Okay? It's not about you. It's really not about you. And all the things that you said are just, you're just making your life about you. But these things get stuck in your head because the devil wants you to only think about you, which leads you to believe that there must be something wrong with you. If they have it and you don't, if they've got the life and you don't got the life, and that mind game you just played with yourself, that's the temptation that I'm talking about. It is a mind game that's causing you to have lust, envy, anger, sadness, anxiety, doubt, you know, all those things the devil wants you to feel, because it makes you very much an I, self-absorbed, oh, my life matters more, God's not going to help me, I this, I that, I da 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 da, all the time. Like, if you find yourself constantly saying I, take a step back, because you are playing a mind game with the devil, and he is truly trying to make you only focus on yourself instead of focusing on God and the people around you. Because the enemy will always try to tempt you at the same time your faith is being tested. Like I said, the two can coexist, and oftentimes those two roads get intertwined and merged together, so it's hard to tell them apart. Think about it this way. God says, wait on me, trust in me. We read that time and time again in the Bible, and yet at the same time, the devil tells us, well, the longer you wait, the older you get. Everyone else you know is married. What's wrong with you? God forgot about you. God's not listening to you. You're not good enough. And so on and so forth. And so much of that just keeps going over and over and over in our heads when we see people get things we don't have. And yet, I want to remind you that part of being and living a godly life and being a child of God is being able to celebrate our brothers and sisters in Christ and being able to celebrate other people's happiness and success. And if you can't do that and you're stuck in this I mentality and this victimizing mentality, You seriously need to double check yourself because you need to be able to be happy for other people. Because how are people supposed to be happy for you? How is God supposed to do something to you if your heart posture is so, God, that's not fair. That's not this. That's not that. Blah, 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 blah. I hear people have those conversations with themselves, and I've known people to be like that. And let's just say I'm not friends with those people. I cannot be friends with that pessimistic mentality of like, oh, they have everything. I have nothing. Like, seriously, you have nothing? Come on. I'm sure you can name 10 things you have that other people don't have. And so when all God wants is for us to be patient, God's asking us to be patient. God is asking us to wait on him because he wants to make a way for us to give us what we need. And the devil is trying to take and everything from that away from us. So the devil tries to make you rush while God tries to make you wait. And the devil tells you, oh, we have to do it before it's too late. And God's like, it's not too late. I still have plenty of time for you, but you need to be ready for it. So let me ask you this. When you hear, oh, before it's too late for who? Because as far as I know, God's never late. He's always on time. And now I say this, but I'm also not going to try to sit here and pretend that I'm Penelope Perfect, okay? Like, it's not like waiting on God is just some easy thing for me either. Because y'all, literally, I was crying about this a few days ago because I was feeling so behind compared to other people. And I see so many people around me getting married, having kids, buying houses, traveling everywhere. And I'm just here like, well, like I said in the beginning, God, did I miss the sign-up sheet? Did I miss something here? Because all I want to do is go to Disney, have more dogs. So I think I'm a little messed up in the head. Like, it's not that it's not important to me. It's not that I don't want those things. But, y'all, it's just not on my mind. And I'm here, like, then I'll, like, get a spiritual slap in the face, or, like, slapped with reality. And it's like, I'm this age, and I genuinely, like, I see people younger than me doing these things, and I'm not doing these things, but like, I'm not unhappy. Like, I love my life. I love my job. I love working hard. I love the fact that I can get to grow this business, have this podcast, have a YouTube, like do all these different things. I love that. I love that I'm exploring photography, trying to grow a photography business, so on and so forth. But then I'm like, I'll get on Instagram. I'll get on Facebook. I'll get on the things and see like, oh, she's married now. Oh, she's engaged now. Oh, she's pregnant now. Interesting. And like you see all these things and it's just kind of like this downward spiral of the heck is wrong with me? Why is that not my life? But in the same token, I genuinely don't think I'm ready for it. I don't. And that was something that kind of hit me last week and a little bit, but honestly, right now as I'm talking to you, that's really hitting me is that I'm not ready for that stage of my life. But the way the devil works on us is whenever I see those pictures or I see those like Facebook posts or whatever, it kind of like it stings a little bit because you're like, dang, like when is that going to happen for me? Because it's not on my mind right now, but I mean, what's crazy is it used to be like years ago when I was younger. That's all I thought about. I was like, I can't wait to be married and have kids and have family and da da da. And now I'm like, bro, I'm still a kid. I'm supposed to have kids. I'm still a kid. Like, literally, all I want to do is go to Disney right now. Like, that sounds so much better than, I don't know, like, yeah, sure, would I like a house for my dogs to run around in the backyard? Absolutely. But man, oh man. Do I think I'm ready for the whole nine yards? No. No, I don't. And I believe that God will bring that to me when he thinks I'm ready. But this is a funny little story that I was going to say because I was talking to my best friend about this last week. Like I said, when I was crying that day, I always text her. She's like my emotional support person. And I said that I just don't even feel like my age because there's people younger than me with multiple kids now. And I even told her that I feel like Buzz Lightyear when he got put in Spanish mode. Like, I'm so lost and confused on that area. And then I was like, well, no, duh, I'm lost. I don't even speak Spanish. Like, shoot. I must have come in one of those packages that said, batteries not included, but you don't realize the batteries aren't included until you get home and you leave the store and you don't have batteries. Like, that's me, man. It's fine. But now I really, really hope.
Batteries not included.
I hope that that made you laugh, but also I want you to know now that you're not alone in feeling this way. And it's okay. So I'm like, I laugh at it. Excuse me, I'm gonna yawn. Whew. Don't get me wrong. Like I said, it does come up in my head, but I truthfully laugh about it because, like I said a couple minutes ago, like, I'm not ready. And yet society wants to make me feel like that's a bad thing. The devil wants to make me feel like, oh, it's too late for you. Like, you need to hurry up and rush into this, which, listen, with marriage, kids, family, all of that, like, that's the last thing I ever want to rush. I can rush my business. I can rush myself in different areas, which, as a whole, I hate rushing. But you get the point. Like, the devil wants to make me rush into things, and I'm going to say it, 99% of the time, when you rush into something, it doesn't work out. It will fall short. It's not what you wanted. It's what you settled for. And so I think that the turning point in this kind of situation lies in what you do when you feel this way. What do you do when society makes you feel bad for where you're at? Because you have to understand that what if God has you waiting on something or waiting for a reason? Like I said, I don't think I'm ready, truly. And I know that the reason that God has me waiting is because of that. Like, I'm not ready. Where my life is at right now, like, if someone, this is completely hypothetical. If I were to be dating someone right now and they would propose to me, I'd be like, bro, I'm like 12. Like, what do you know? Like, and I'm not saying that I'm immature. I'm not saying anything like that. I'm just saying that, like, I don't feel like I'm in a stage of my life where that is something that God just has on my heart or wants me to do right now. Even in a dating aspect, like, my heart is not in that area of life, and that's okay. But I always have to remind myself of that when society wants to make me feel like I'm wrong or like I'm getting older and it's too late for me. And like, how are you supposed to do this? Like, there's not that many single people left. Yeah, I get that. But I also believe in a God that has someone picked out for me. And I believe that He is preparing the two of us for each other. So point number two is, you're not ready for what God wants to give you. I know that there's a lot of people like that. And sometimes I'm one of them. I'm not ready. But I've acknowledged that. Let's talk about it in the other aspect. So have you ever thought about that, though? Like, have you ever thought about, like, you know what? Maybe God wants to give me something that I'm not ready for. Or maybe, like, He's preparing me still. Maybe I'm still in training. Like, there's so many other things to think about when it comes to why you haven't gotten the things. Like, why haven't I seen the blessing? So on and so forth. Like, you haven't gotten it because, like I said, you're not ready yet. You're not in that stage of life. You haven't learned the things you need to learn. You're not prepared for what God has. And, like, you have to understand that that's okay. I'd rather train and be ready and be prepared than be underprepared or to mess up or what, anything along those lines. So remember this. Maybe you're not ready for the blessing and you still need more training. So while you think you're lost and behind, God wants to change you, but He can't do that when you throw this little pity party for yourself. He can't do that for you. If you sit there with your toxic mindset and your negativity, how is God supposed to change you? Because what if God is trying to give you something, but you can't see it because of your attitude? Are you starting to realize what the devil is doing? Like, as I'm talking, are you starting to understand that? Because here's the thing. You get stuck in this season of me, why me, why not, when is it going to be my time, blah, 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 due to your attitude. Because your attitude is preventing your training, which henceforth increases the time it takes to see the blessing. Because you still need the training. Like, God's not just going to be like, well, I wanted her to wait a year. I was going to try to change her or him. But, you know, the year's up. They haven't changed. It's okay. I'll still give it to... No. God's going to be like, well, you still have a year's worth of training. And the longer it takes you to realize that, the longer it takes me to give you what I want to give you. And another thing you need to think about is your prayers. Because you can't be ready for what God wants to give you if you're not praying the right prayers. Now, before you get mad at me, let me explain. If you're praying for things that God doesn't want for you or have for you, no, he's not going to answer. Or he's going to answer with a no. And because of where your attitude is, you now start to really believe about all the things that the devil is telling you. So I implore you to be specific, be intentional, be purposeful with your prayers. Realize the things you don't receive are not meant for you. So if you're praying for something and you never get it, it is not that God is denying you in a way where he's like, nope, they don't deserve that, or blah, 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 or like he's keeping something from you. It's just that you don't need it. So why is he going to let you have it? Think about a kid who, okay, this is going to be a little crazy example. Are you going to let a kid put a fork in an electric outlet? No, absolutely not. Are you going to let them play with an electric outlet? Absolutely not. Why? Because they'll get electrocuted. And what if the kid cries and screams and, Mom, Dad, please just let me put the fork in the... No. No. Because I know what happens if you do that. The kid doesn't. Guess what? You're God's kid. He knows what happens if you get that or you do that or you receive that. You don't. And we have such a good God that he never lets us go without. And so I want to read you Deuteronomy chapter 30, verses 1 through 3. It says, in the future, when you experience all these blessings and curses I have listed for you, and when you are living among the nations to which the Lord your God has exited for you, take to heart all of these instructions. If at that time you and your children return to the Lord your God, and if you obey with all your heart and all your soul and all the commands I have given you today, then the Lord your God will restore your fortunes. He will have mercy on you and gather you back from all the nations where he has scattered you. So, if you trust in God, he will not only give you what you deserve, but he will give you back all the things that you lost tenfold. I truly believe that. I truly believe that God is not a God of lack, that he is a God of abundance. But the thing is, he also is a God of protection. So he sometimes has to protect us from ourselves. Because with that being said, like, I'm sure you've said or heard someone else say stuff like, God's not listening to me, God doesn't hear me. And what I want to say to that is, how would you know if God's listening to you or if he hears you when you aren't praying specific prayers? Like I said, you need to be intentional with your prayers. And you need to have faith in God that what he's not giving you is not meant for you, and that he wants to give you certain things. But if you're not praying for those things, how are you supposed to see that he's given it to you? Does that make sense? Like, how would you know if God answers you or the devil answers you if you're not being specific? Because the devil hears your prayers, guys. In case you didn't know that, he hears you. Because I want to make you aware that if you feel lost, you might be feeling lost because you're on the wrong path. So like I said, the devil hears you. He hears your prayers. So when you talk about something like, okay, most common one ever. God, I just want a relationship. God, I want a marriage. Okay. The devil says, okay, I'll give you a relationship. I'll give you a marriage. But if you say, God, I want the marriage that you have for me. I want the person that you have picked out for me. I want the relationship that you have for me. And you say, I want what you want for me, not what I want for myself. That's when you're going to be able to differentiate whether it's from God or from the enemy. Because the enemy will come to bring chaos every chance he gets, where God wants to bring you peace. So this person, this thing, this place, all the things that God has for you will give you peace. The devil will not give you peace. So when the devil answers you and you feel lost, it's because you're, like I said, you're going down the wrong path. And the devil does not take care of you. He does not guide you. He does not love you or anything else the way that God would. So if you are walking with the enemy instead of God, you're walking in the dark. So of course you're confused. Of course you're lost. And remember how I said you're probably not ready? Well, how could you be ready if you're not walking with God? Now, the last point that I want to make switches gears a little bit. Because point number three is, You're trying too hard. You are trying too hard. How fun is that to think about? One second, you're like, oh, I'm not doing it enough, and the next second, I'm telling you, you're trying too hard. What a fun game. So, this is an analogy for you. And I know this has happened to at least one of us. At least one of you listening, this has happened. Don't try to tell me it hasn't. It's happened to me. So, if anything, just picture me doing this. Have you ever tried to open something, like a jar or like a box or just whatever? Like, you're just trying to open something and it won't open. Like, you're doing literally everything. Like, if you're like me, you're the person who's like, no, I'm not going to get the knife and open it. Like, I'm going to open it. Or if it's a jar, you're kind of just like, I got this. And you're squeezing and you're squeezing and now your hand hurts and you have like the whole like shirt on the jar trying to like pop it open. You've hit it on stuff and it's just not opening. And then you give up. You put it on the counter and you're just like frustrated. Like, what the heck? Why can't I open this? And then someone comes along and boop, it opens. And you're like, you just sit there and you're like, well, I loosened it up for you. No, you didn't. Sorry. You didn't. But holy frustration. Listen, that's what you're doing with God. You are trying to open this jar that only God can open. And it's so easy for him to open it. But you're trying to force it. And so when you're trying to open this jar, like you're picturing that, I want you to also think that that's what you're doing when you're trying to fight God and do everything alone and on your own. See how I said you're trying too hard? You are trying to do everything. You're trying to open your jar of blessings from God before you're ready for them, but it's only because you want them. Not because God's ready to give them to you, not because God said, here's your jar. It's like you found the jar and you're like, oh, blessings. And you tried to open it like Smeagol from Lord of the Rings, guarding his ring and wanting his ring. That's you right now with your blessings, wanting them so bad. And you're not ready for them. They don't belong to you yet. They're not meant to be in your life yet. Because if God were to give you them, you'd mess it up. So you need to understand too that the jar is not yours to open in the first place. Just like your life isn't yours. Both of these things belong to God. So while you're wrestling with this and trying to do everything on your own, you're getting tired. In come the devil's mental game. This is why I wanted to point out that you're probably trying too hard. And so my other bookmark in Galatians chapter 6 verses 8 through 9, it says, those who live only to satisfy their own sinful nature will harvest decay and death from that sinful nature. But those who live to please the Spirit will harvest everlasting life from the Spirit. So let's not get tired of doing what is good. At just the right time, we will reap a harvest of blessings if we don't give up. And then I want to read verse 10. Therefore, whenever we have the opportunity, we should do good to everyone, especially to those in the family of faith. Just like it says, let's read that again. So let's not get tired. Because when you're tired, the devil is going to get you. He is going to use your mental tiredness. He is going to use that fatigue, that exhaustion, that emotional tiredness that you are feeling right now, and he is going to use it against you, and you are just going to find yourself drifting farther from God. So, let me ask you this. Are you trying to be the ruler of your life and do things on your timeline? Because guess what? Your timeline doesn't exist. You're either going to end up on the devil's timeline, or you can choose to be on God's timeline. Which one would you rather be on? Because sometimes God's going to make you wait. But I would rather be on God's timeline than the devil's timeline. So if you feel lost, you know, you probably are lost. You probably are in the wilderness. Hate to break it to you. You probably are. Or you're on the devil's time clock, which is an unknown time clock, if I'm being honest. It's like that time when you were a kid that just had the little dashes and the arrows and you're like, I don't know what's what. That's the devil's timeline. I don't know what's what. I don't know where I'm at. I don't know what day it is. I don't know what time it is. I just know the sun's up. Oh, nope, sun's down. Like, literally, what's the devil's timeline? So, I know when I feel the most lost, it's when I'm the most tired. And that's kind of why I wanted to point out on point number three that you're trying too hard. Because when I'm the most tired, that's when the devil is louder, which means the negativity is louder. Y'all, my mistakes, my choices, your mistakes, your choices are not God's fault. The tiredness that we do to ourselves is not God's fault. Because the feeling of being lost is also not God's fault. God is trying to pull us back. He doesn't want us to be lost at sea. He doesn't want us to have all this doubt. He doesn't want us to be tired all the time. We do it to ourselves. And so I want you to think about when Peter walked on water with Jesus. He had faith in Jesus, and he walked on water, and then all of a sudden, doubt creeped in. And what happened when doubt creeped in? He sank. And Jesus said, "Ye of little faith." So where is your faith? You ever wondered that you're only lost at sea because you're looking in the wrong direction? You're paddling in the wrong direction? Are you even the one steering the boat? Or is the devil steering the boat? Because, you know, they say in the Bible, faith without works is dead. God's giving you the boat. He's giving you the oars. And he's also that light that you're supposed to go towards. So do the work and steer yourself towards the light. Choose God's timeline. Choose God's path for you. And let him do the things for you that need to be done. Let him train you. If you feel lost, accept it. Accept that you feel lost and call on God to help you get out of the wilderness, to get out of this frustrated state of mind, to help you be you again, to help you live the life that he wants you to live, because that's what he wants for you. God does not want, like I said, he doesn't want you confused. He doesn't want you lost, because he knows when you're lost and confused, the devil is working on you. God loves you. The devil doesn't. That lost feeling that you have, the being lost at sea feeling, that's not from God. I'm sorry, but you did it to yourself and you've put yourself in this position, and the only way back is to call on God. The only way back is to give your life to God and to trust that he is supposed to lead you and that he will lead you, and that all the things you don't have are not from him and you don't need them anyway. So why do you want them? And you also need to stop comparing your life to other people's lives, because you are not them and they are not you. Sure, they may have gotten married years before you. They may have 2 kids, 3 kids by now. But I also know a lot of people that got married young that are divorced, that ended up in abusive relationships. Do you want that? I don't want that. And if that means I have to wait a couple more years, then so be it. Because if I am going to have a relationship or the life that God wants me to have, it's going to take some training. It's going to take some preparation. But I would rather wait for that than rush into something and it just fail. So stop rushing. Stop settling. Allow God to work on you. And like I said, if you're lost, accept that you're lost and ask God to lead you out of that lostness. Lostness. Wilderness. I could have said that, but whatever. Lostness. That's Loch Ness Monster. Allow God to lead you out of it. I promise you he can, and I promise you he wants to. The only thing that is preventing you from the life that you want, from the life that God has, is you. Your beliefs, your attitude, your prayers, your faith. All of that is on you. And you are preventing you. You are preventing God, because God is not going to force you to do anything. He's not going to force anything into your life. He's going to protect you. He's going to watch over you. He's going to be there for you. And he's also going to try to protect you from you. But at the same time, why I say he's going to try to do that is because it's truly up to you. It's truly up to you if you're going to let God lead you or not. So I want you to ask yourself that. Whose timeline are you on? And if you're someone who's had the belief of it's too late for who? It's never too late for God. So, I hope you think about that. And I hope you start to really change the way you think. Because I know God loves you. I know God loves me. And I know that everything I have and everything I don't have is because it's what I need and what I don't need. So, I hope you enjoyed this podcast. I hope it made you learn a little something. I hope you are able to take some notes and kind of be like, just think about it, really. Think about where you're at in life. And I hope you come back for the next episode. And I hope you rate this podcast. It really helps me out. It's free to do, just saying. If you like, rate, comment, it really helps me out. I really want to know how I can help you. Helps me end further conversations with y'all. If you want more like real life tea, if you want some real life situations, which I think I'm doing, I think I'm balancing that pretty well, but I would really like to know if you think I am. So please go ahead and like the podcast, comment, rate it. Let me know what's going on. If this really spoke to you, please share it with someone. Really appreciate it. They'll appreciate it too. Everyone deserves to know whether they're lost at sea or not. And I hope you come back for the next episode. But like I always say, never forget that you are fearfully and wonderfully made. God loves you. You're doing great. And don't give up.